Now here's a way to dress up a cabinet that has a false back, one of those thin panels that you get from IKEA, Target, and a lot of common furniture has this. To remove the false backing, buy fabric with a pattern and glue it to the back and then staple it back on. We'll show you how. Here's an example of a cabinet we bought that has glass doors. And it has one of those false backs like I described. And we just remove the screws, or often they're little tiny nails. And once removed, we have access to that panel. Here's our back panel, in this case before assembly, but very easy to remove if it was already built. Here's our pattern. We give ourselves about an inch overlap, and we're gonna cut that. Now before we did this, we measured the back panel, and then we purchased a piece of fabric that fit that size with a bit of giving about an inch of overlap, and then we ironed it first. Here on cutting it. Now we're not going to put any glue on the face of it, it'll all be on the back side here where we're going to fold the material over. In this case we have some pre-drilled holes. So what we're going to do afterwards is use a marker and feel through the fabric where those holes were to indicate where to put the screws. Here's our fabric, which we purchased on clearance from Hobby Lobby, and we also got some decorative knobs that were very inexpensive. Once we've centered it, we're going to apply our glue from a glue gun.
You can put it on the fabric or on the
panel.
Make sure it's tight. Okay.
And here Lisa's applying it to the panel.
Make sure the fabric is nice and tight. They're under.
So we're folding the corner under here.
Just adding a little more glue.
A little more glue just to get rid of that excess. And the final touch, it'll look something like this. The opposite side looks nice and smooth because we pulled it tight as we glued along. In this case, we have some pre-drilled holes that we want to match up and that we covered here. So I'm going to go along with a sewing needle and a Sharpie and see if I can't match those holes up so I know where to drill. Once I find my hole, I mark it with a needle, a sewing pin, and then I mark it with a Sharpie after that. Now I've got my holes marked with Sharpie marker ink, and keep in mind that this process is totally unnecessary if you're using a staple gun or if you just have those little tack nails to pound it through. And so our final product, as you can see, dressed up a little bit with some nice decorative things, Hobby Lobby half price for the knobs, and turn an ordinary piece of furniture into something interesting and something to talk about.